Hello, everybody. Today we are going to talk about Dharma. And before I get into it, what is Dharma in a nutshell? Well, first of all, you have to know what religion we're even talking about, because there's Buddhist Dharma, and then there's Hindu Dharma, and there are, I'm 100% certain that there are, the concept of Dharma will actually be pretty familiar to you when I do start to explain what it is, but it is a concept that I think you can find in a lot to almost all religions. But today we are talking about the Hindu version of Dharma. There's Dharma in lots of religions, but I don't think that it's not called Dharma. You know what I mean? So, but we're going to talk about Hindu Dharma. What is Dharma? And if you're like me and you kind of need things like in a nutshell, you know, Dharma is basically your duty. That is probably the best way I've heard it described. It can also be called doing the right thing, but I think that that is subjective to each person. And so I think doing your duty is more accurate, because to some people, their version of doing the right thing is doing the what's best for them. But the concept of Dharma is that what's best for you is not always best for everyone else. Dharma also implies that these are like laws and rules of the universe. And I know recently someone made an offhanded comment about, well, what's right is subjective. And to a point, I agree. But I think that when, it's hard to explain, because everything in life, the way I look at it is I look at it like statistics. You know, you have your average, and then you have your outliers that are outside of the average or outside of the norm. And I'm not saying what is normal is right, but even in these concepts of like, it's really hard to give an example because they're kind of more taboo topics, but it's that sort of idea of if you're not hurting anybody, then it's not technically wrong. But I think everyone can agree, you know, at least everybody that we want in society, you know, the point of society is not that one person is more important than all the others. And so we have to do what's best for everyone within a certain set of rules or standards, which would be, you know, if it's not hurting another person's liberties, basically, if it's not impeding your pursuit of happiness. That's kind of what Dharma is, sort of, because it's not something that you, it's not something you can change, but it is something that's like, it's the struggle between free will and fate. Fate cannot be changed. Fate is like, here is fate, big circle, and then free will is inside of fate. So the thing is you can't change what people are going to do, if they're going to follow their dharma or not, if they're going to do their duty or not. You can't control that. And really, what a person chooses is predetermined and predestined by fate. And how we differentiate between what is good and what is bad has to do with, you know, is your free will aligned with, you know, are you doing what God wants you to do of your own free will, or are you doing what you want to do? And Dharma would be doing what God wants you to do. So to give you an example, I'll give you a few examples here. Let's say someone is rude to me Okay, I can either lash out at them or maybe try to take a more intelligent approach, right? Taking the intelligent approach and being more compassionate and not just, basically jumping down somebody's throat, that would be doing your dharma, doing your duty. Because you can't just I can't go to work and just do absolutely whatever I want. I have to do my duty. We have a duty to others. We have a duty to society, A good example is like a king. A king has his kingly duties, right? Which is technically to watch over all the people in his kingdom. And if he does that, he is fulfilling his dharma. When the king does what he wants and lives selfishly, he's not doing his duty. He's just doing what he wants to do. And so that is kind of the concept of dharma, but it applies to all things in the universe. Like a tree's dharma is to grow and bear fruit or what have you, And our dharma is part of caring for the tree. We all care for each other. It's that sort of thing. And when you are doing your dharma, you're not just doing whatever you want to do. Like I said, that's why I prefer using the term dharma duty rather than saying the right thing to do, because one person could be like, well, it's right for me. Like someone, like for example, you might steal something. And because you just want it, and you don't want to pay for it and you don't want to work for it. That would be in violation of your dharma. And if it was just, for selfish reasons, like if you're starving to death, like, yes, go steal some food from somebody. Not somebody who also needs food. Go steal some from the store. I'm giving you permission. Don't come knocking on my door being like, she told me I could. But no, it's that sort of thing. Like, so if you're doing something out of selfishness and out of just your own self-interest, that's not doing your dharma duty. So, when you are fulfilling your dharma, that would be like taking care of an elderly person. I know that's a really specific example, specific to me. But that's the thing. It's not always easy. It's not always fun. It's not always rainbows, unicorns, butterflies, and candy canes and bullshit. It's hard, And so, but the thing is that is the law of the universe, basically. It's what all things conform to, or they're supposed to. It's the natural way that things are meant to unfold. And so, really, in that concept, the only things which are unnatural are things which go against dharma. So, being selfish, killing people for no reason, hurting people for no reason other than you want to, only caring about yourself, basically. It's almost like that idea of, everything is connected, which is a Hindu concept. We're all connected. And it's basically being in violation of that. If you are conducting your life with no regard for anyone else or anything else, you're not doing your dharma. You're not doing your duty in the world. You're not, I want to say, holding up your end of the bargain, or you're not pulling your weight. There you go. You're not pulling your weight in the situation. You're just basically taking advantage of everyone else who is doing their dharma. And that throws everything into an unbalance. And the reason why dharma is important and why it's important to do your dharma is because everybody's actions have a consequence. And sometimes, like let's say for example, because this happens the Mahabharata, which is a Hindu text, by the way. It would be like when Duryodhan tries to usurp the throne from Yudhishthir, I want to say. And I also just want to say, if at any point I say something wrong or you're not sure or you really want to know if I'm telling the truth, I could just be lying. I could just be lying to you right now. Go and research it for yourself. Go and look it up for yourself. And, or like when Duryodhan tries to disrobe Draupadi? For some reason, I just forgot how to say her name because Duryodhan's name messed me up. But it would be like that. Like, he wasn't doing his duty to the king by basically trying to steal his throne from him. And so he wasn't doing his dharma. He was kind of in it for selfish reasons, if that makes sense. And like what I said, fate, like it was fate for this to happen because people in the past, his own father was not controlling his ambition. And so that got imbued into his son. And so then his son's ambition and his son's ego became so large that he decided to basically do all these horrible things to his own brothers, the Pandavas, and basically, yeah, all this bad stuff happened. And the thing is that is their fate, and you can't escape fate. But the problem is that fate and free will are kind of like woven into each other. Like, it is your fate to perform your free will, but whether or not your free will is aligned with Dharma or is not decides ultimately where things are going. But fate and predestiny, it's hard to describe and make sense of how you can have free will, but then something is also predetermined because people assume that fate is outside of their hands, or people have this concept of, well, I just decided it, so it can't be fate. But it could be fate that you are deciding these things and that you're doing these things because you're not understanding things like dharma and like prakriti and just Hindu concepts like that. You're not understanding religious duty and your duty to your fellow man. So you might think that you are deciding to do these things, but it was already predestined by your lack of understanding that you would do these things. And so that is also why it was the Pandavas' destiny and fate to basically be victimized by their brother. It's not right, but it was what was going to happen anyway, the way things were going, if that makes sense. Like, something starts, you put someone in front of a train and then the train hits them, and you can be like, it was fate, but it's like, okay, but you moved them over there. So, yes, it was fate, but it was only fate because you have these evil intentions, if that makes sense. So, and you might be asking, well, why would God give someone evil intentions? But the thing that you're not realizing is that is that person's free will. God is not deciding that. God already decided that we all need to follow Dharma. We all need to follow these principles for the best life for everyone. And when you don't do, like, those are the things that are decided, and what you choose to do with them is up to you. But God has already shown you the way. Okay, so that's basically what dharma is. And if you're not doing your dharma duty, then it's basically just bad stuff. You're just doing bad stuff. And so that is the concept of everybody's actions also influence all of society. So if everybody stopped performing their dharma, and if everybody just was out for themselves and out to do whatever, and we thought that was right, then basically everybody on earth would just be suffering. So the reason why we know that those things are wrong is because people would suffer if we did that. So that's what you have to think is, well, will it really matter if I stop doing my dharma? it will, because everything we do matters. And there are different levels of things that different levels of importance. But like I said, if you take the example of the king, he's really supposed to help other people. And the reason why, you know, it's to help the subjects of the kingdom. And so if he doesn't do that, then everyone will suffer. But he'll be happy, you know, for a limited time. But the thing is then, if you think about it, I'm going to jump to a different time and a different country real quick. But the French Revolution, what happened in France? You know, we have the king and the queen and the powers that be abusing their power. And, you know, you can think that that's all right and that's all this and that. But the thing is when one person breaks their dharma, then this whole system of interconnectedness gets severed and gets frayed and breaks down. So then what happened to the French rulers? They were revolted against by their people and they were killed. And you know what happened in the Mahabharata when, you know, when Duryodhan tried to usurp the throne from Yudhishthir? Is there was a battle and there was a war, and Krishna said that, you know, I don't like war, but that's what's going to happen because they did this stuff. And they, you know, when you don't live in a godly way, evil things will happen. Ba-da-ba! Like, that's it, you know? So that's basically the idea of dharma. It's just doing your duty, doing the right thing. And yeah. You know, and there are always people who are going to take things to like extremes, but I think that if you're a good person and you're not hurting anybody, then really that's all there is to it. Like if you're not hurting anybody, there you go. But, you know, even in any society, everybody has to have a job, you know. If someone can't work, it is their duty to provide something. It might not be like a product because, you know, your worth is not linked to your productivity. Sometimes it can just be of the mind. Sometimes, you know, it is our duty to care for those who are less fortunate simply because that could be us. One day we could be the one who can't work and can't do this and can't do that. And, you know, if those kinds of people are considered useless to a society, then that just opens up a gateway to more violence, basically, and more hurt. And then you get to the point where you can say, well, this person, that person, the other person's not good for society. But in reality, we all have to do our duty. And sometimes the dharma of a person is to be dependent, because the dharma of another person is to be needed by the dependent person. Like, for example, I'm thinking of like my residents who can't really do a lot for themselves. But the thing is they already did their dharma in their life. And now it's my dharma to serve them and help them basically pass over into the next phase of life. And they're still doing their dharma. Like I said, it's an intellectual thing. They're still trying to help in whatever way they can. And even though, you know, even though sometimes, you know, the whole phrase about the road to hell is paved with good intentions, that comes from the concept too of no one can do good on their own. Only God can do good deeds. And so that's why, you know, you might think you're doing, that's why sometimes you try to do your dharma, but it doesn't always turn out right. But just because someone else is disrupting their own dharma and not doing theirs, and then it clashes with yours. But we have to remember not to be like dominoes. Like I said before, you know, the king pushes his people to the point where they revolt and all this. But if the king had been doing his dharma, then he wouldn't have pushed so hard against the people to collapse them into, you know, and I'm not saying that, you know, it was right to kill the king and queen, but maybe they just shouldn't have been king and queen anymore, you know. But the other thing is, yeah, like I said, when you disrupt your dharma, you disrupt other people's dharma too. And so then it's kind of that thing where, like, when you're not doing your job, and so that makes everyone else's jobs harder, so you're actually hurting other people. That is part of it. So I hope that that kind of made sense. I'm not really sure where else to go with it. But yeah, it's basically that whole thing of, you know, for a society to work, we all have to work together. And, you know, but it's not just about society. It could be anything. Like, a bee's dharma is to collect honey, as they say, you know. And so it is this natural, instinctual part of us that just wants to do what is right and do what is good. And sometimes you might have this instinct of wanting to do something bad, but the logic of the situation, you know, like I said, that's why it doesn't make sense for it to just be what's right, because what is right is not always, it can be right for us, but it's not always like fun to deal with. You know, work isn't fun, but always. So, it is that thing of, you know, like if you don't want food to rot, you put it in the fridge. Maybe, I don't know who this would be difficult for, but it takes a level of work. You know, it takes a level of work. It's not a lot, but it takes a level of work to get up and go do this and perform the actions, you know, to make sure the meat doesn't rot on the counter. You know, basically as simple as that. And so that is why dharma is considered a good thing to do. And so just today, I would try to ask you to do a little exercise if you want to today, where you just try to think of, you know, what is my dharma in this situation? Or what is my dharma? How am I contributing to just society? How am I contributing to, and that doesn't have to be in the context of like a capitalistic sort of thing where you have to produce something. You know, it could be as much as, you know, playing with your pet or something. You know, it is your dharma to, you know, care for your pet, and to be kind. It's your pet's dharma to protect you and to, you know, bark when someone comes to the door to let you know. And just basically like that. It's like that instinctual need that we all have to fulfill this universal law that exists between all of us once we realize that we're all connected and we all have a response. We're all our brother's keeper, basically, to give you another example of it. You know, he's like, Cain is like, am I my brother's keeper? And it's like, yeah, you are. You know, you are responsible for what happens as a result of your actions. That's why when you don't follow your dharma and you don't follow right living and you don't perform good actions in the world, bad things will happen to others, and they will eventually happen to you because that is getting into your karma. And maybe that's what we should talk about next time is karma. Okay, so but just focus on dharma for today. Ask yourself, what is my dharma? All right. Peace.